Introduce, I would like to welcome you for today's lesson. My name is Teacher Dawson, and we are going to start about history, grade 7. And we are going to learn more about the colonial invasion in Africa in a wide way, various concepts related with this topic. So make sure you prepare your learning materials where you are. Now, today's lesson is colonial invasion in Africa. Particularly, we are going to learn about the concepts relating with this topic. Now, we have various concepts relating with the colonial invasion. That is, before you have to know about them. Number one, it is about the invasion. Meaning of invasion. Yeah, when we say invasion, is an act of entering in a particular place without the consent of the natives or indigenous of that place. That is the meaning of invasion. Is an act of entering in a particular place without the consent of the natives. So the meaning of invasion, as one of the term there, it is an act of entering in a particular place or area without the consent of the natives. But another term is colonial invasion. Now, colonial invasion refers to the ways or situation whereby the Europeans entered or came in our country or continent without our consent or will. So when it says colonial invasion refers to the way or situation whereby the Europeans entered or came in our continent or in our country without our consent or will. That is the meaning of colonial invasion. But remember, I've seen the meaning of this term invasion, that is an act of entering a particular place without the will or concept of the natives. That is the meaning of these two terms. But also, we have another term that you need to know, because here we have seen colonial invasion. We have another term which is known as colonialism. So colonialism is the police or situation whereby the strong nations dominate the weak nation. So the colonialism is the policy or situation whereby the strong nations dominating the weak nation. But because you have said that our topic is colonial invasion in Africa, that is the colonialist or the Europeans came in our continent and invaded our continent without the will of the natives. And these European nations or capitalists who entered in our country or continent or who came in our continent without our will are as follows. So let us mention examples of the colonialist or capitalist nations. Capitalist nations invaded our continent. So the Europeans or capitalist nations which invaded our continent, including Tanganyika, are as follows. Number one, it is Britain. Number two, France. Number three, Italy. Number four, Belgium. Number five, Germany. Spain, as well as Portugal. So these were European nations, which invaded our continent before the struggle for the independence. So these nations that you have mentioned were the capitalist nations which invaded our continent. But remember the colonial invasion. When the colonial invasion took place, you can ask this question. When the colonial invasion took place, now the colonial invasion took place during 19th century, soon after the Bareilly Conference. So the invasion, the massive invasion of Europeans took place in 19th century, soon after the Bareilly Conference. Remember the Bareilly Conference, the conference which was held to partition the continent of Africa among European nations. So this the invasion took place in that century, 19th century, after Bareilly Conference. Now, there were strategic areas that the Europeans invaded. Not all areas of the entire continent of Africa was invaded. There were areas with economic potentialities that the Europeans invaded mostly. Areas scrambled before or invaded mostly by the Europeans. That is called strategic areas. Strategic areas invaded in Africa. Now, strategic areas which were invaded in Africa, as I said, were those areas with the economic potentialities. Were those areas with economic potentialities. Areas with economic potentialities, such as availability of raw materials such as minerals, fertile land, good climatic condition, and the other potentialities. So areas with the following potentialities were mostly scrambled by the Europeans. Number one, areas with the minerals deposit, such as gold, diamond. These areas were intensively scrambled by these European nations. Another potentiality, fertile land. Areas with the fertile lands were also invaded by the Europeans intensively. Navigable rivers. Areas with navigable rivers or water bodies were also intensively scrambled. Another areas intensively scrambled, areas with cool climate, as well as populated areas. populated in areas, areas with large number of people. And for the aim, these areas were invented for the aim of getting the cheap laborers. So let us mention strategic areas which were intensively scrambling in Africa. Number one, Egypt and the Nile Valley. Egypt and the Nile Valley. These areas were very important during scramble for and partition. Particularly, this area was just scrambled by France as well as British. Another area which was intensively scrambled, it was Congo Basin. Congo Basin or Congo River. And I remember this was given to King Leopold II of Belgium. So this area also was intensively scrambled. Another area, it is in Africa, it is the Niger Delta. The Niger Delta or Niger Basin in West Africa. Also, this area was intensively scrambled by the French, as well as British. Another area intensively scrambled in Africa, it is about the East Africa, as well as South Africa. So these are some of the areas whereby the Europeans intensively scrambled this one for these reasons we have seen. Areas because they were scrambling because there were areas with the economic potential such as mineral deposits, fertile land, navigable rivers, cool climate, and populated areas. Now, for the case of Tanganyika, there were various regions or zones which were invaded by the Europeans. There were various reasons. For example, areas such as Moshi, Kilimanjaro, Arusha, Iringa. Tanga. So these were some of the regions or zones which were invaded by the Europeans in an intensive way. That is about in Tanganyika. Now you can ask, what were the reasons behind for the colonial invasion? Why Europeans invaded our continent? Why the British, French, Germans, and other Europeans invaded in our continent. Reasons for colonial invasion. Reasons for the colonial invasion. Reasons for colonial invasion. Now, one of the main reasons for colonial invasion, it is industrial revolution. The main reason for colonial invasion, it was attributed by the industrial revolution in Europe, which took place between 18th century to 19th century. Industrial revolution. As we, industrial revolution, this was the period in Europe whereby there was massive innovation of various machines as well as in production that contributed to the various resources and lead to the colonial invasion in our continent. And the first country to undergo industrial revolution, it was known as Britain, the first country to undergo the Industrial Revolution in Europe, it was known as Britain or England. And it was between 1750 to 1850, between that duration. Now, reasons. As I said earlier, that industrial revolution contributed to the colonial inversion in Africa. Now, the industrial revolution attributed various circumstances in Europe which led to the European to search various areas so as to invest the investment to search areas for their areas for markets as well as other reasons. So the industrial revolution contributed to the demand or the following demands. The demands which were contributed by the industrial revolution, which eventually lead to the occurrence of colonial inversion. One, it was the need for for raw materials. The need for raw materials. Now, as I said earlier, industrial revolution took place in Europe, which reached a point whereby the Europeans lacked raw materials. Now, the best way to fit the problem or to solve the problem, they decided to come in Africa to search for raw materials so as to continue feeding their industries and continue producing. Another reason it was the need for markets. The Europeans, as one of the demand contributed by industrial revolution, the Europeans came to a continent for the purpose of searching a market for their industrial produced goods. Another reason it was about the need for investment. The need for the investment. Now, due to the investment which took place there in Europe, the Europeans, they opted to come in our continent to continue investing in our continent, because there in Europe, the investment was not profitable to them. That's why they decided to find other places so as to invest and earn more profit. And that's why they came to colonize and invade our continent. But also, industrial revolution contributed to the need for cheap labor. Need for cheap labor. They wanted cheap labor so as to help them in their forced production areas, such as mining areas, plantation areas. They needed laborers to work or to help them in their production processes. But another reason for the contributed by the industrial revolution is the need for establishment of settlement. The Europeans wanted to establish their settlement in Africa, particularly to those areas with the economic potentialities we have mentioned them. And then when these Europeans came and settled in our continent, they were called the settlers. So all of these were the reasons behind for the colonial invasion, which was contributed by the industrial revolution, led to the demands of the following them. Raw materials, markets, investment, cheap laborers, as well as settlement areas. Now, the concept relating with the colonial invasion in Africa. Few comments that we have passed through from the beginning of the lesson to where we have reached. So these are the concepts relating to the colonial invasion, and I would like to end up there for today, so we shall proceed with our next lesson. But remember, today we have learned about the concept of colonial invasion, the meaning of colonial invasion, as well as reasons for the colonial invasion. But before, I would like to give you one question for homework discussion. One question. Now, this: What were the main reasons for the colonial invasion in Africa. So this question is now for you for a vision while you are at home. What were the main reasons for the colonial inversion? So I would like to end up there and thank you for your cooperation and for listening to me. That is the end of our lesson. We shall meet next lesson. Thank you.